The order of operations are the rules regarding which procedures to perform first when evaluating a mathematical expression. They're usually given as follows. First, you evaluate what's inside brackets, then you evaluate exponents and roots, followed by multiplication and division, and finally addition and subtraction. And whenever two operators are of equal precedence, you evaluate whichever is to the left first. Depending on where you are from, you might have been taught a fancy acronym and a fun mnemonic. It's clear, easy to learn, memorable, has caused pain and suffering to millions of people, and has been actively making the general public worse at math. Many others before me have tried to explain why PEMDAS is terrible, and in my opinion, most of them have done a poor job of it, and the currently most viewed example on YouTube is no exception. Particularly, it states that in PEMDAS, you're supposed to evaluate multiplication before division, and every commenter and their grandma has pointed out that that's not what PEMDAS says. If you're one of these people, that makes you two things, correct and part of the problem. One question you need to ask yourself is, if the rules are so straightforward, why is there so much disagreement on the topic? Is it just misunderstanding? Have people been taught incorrectly? Sure, for some, but when Facebook math problems can make headlines, gain millions of views, and spark internet-wide flame wars, I think it's reasonable to assume there's something deeper going on. Or perhaps the simpler answer is that these rules aren't nearly as straightforward as you think. While not in this case, PEMDAS has some straight-up ambiguities, like unary operations. How do they fit into the hierarchy? It doesn't tell you. What about stacked exponents? PEMDAS will tell you it should be interpreted like this, and that's wrong. This means to multiply a number with itself this many times, and then multiplying the result of that this many times. And since saying do 5 lots of something 3 times is exactly the same as 5 times 3, you can just write it as 2 to the 5 times 3. So interpreting this to mean this is completely redundant, and therefore no one does. But outside of these specific cases, you are still... you are just straight up wrong. Sure, that might have been what you've been taught, but that's not true for everyone. Like, by a long shot. Some people have been taught that multiplication comes before division, and not just by mistake. Here's a mathematics style guide that explicitly states as much. Calculators vary wildly in whether they follow PEMDAS, and most published papers don't at all. And when most of the entire professional fields of mathematics, science, and engineering disagree with you, that's usually a sign you need to re-examine your position. All of these examples were stolen from The How and Why of Mathematics. See her videos for a much more detailed deep dive. This rule set is almost entirely exclusive to primary school, and an accompanying acronym and limerick to the English-speaking ones. How can it be that we ended up in a situation where the education system and the professional field can completely contradict each other on such a crucial topic? Oh no, I'm not an historian. Okay, I hear you say, straw man I just made up. So the system has some holes and every mathematician thinks I'm wrong. But I doubt the majority of people who respond to Facebook math problems have a PhD. PEMDAS and its equivalents are still the most widespread system taught to the layman, so how come they're still getting it wrong? Well, I'm glad you asked. While many have explored how PEMDAS is ambiguous, comparatively few people have asked why it's so unintuitive. One way we could try and find out is by seeing what system actual mathematicians use and why they prefer it over PEMDAS. Implied multiplication, or multiplication by juxtaposition, is when you multiply two variables by putting them next to each other, and this is usually interpreted to have higher precedence than regular multiplication and division. To see why this is useful, let's pit it against PEMDAS to see how they handle this expression. If we want to divide first, PEMDAS can just evaluate left to right and get the correct results. If we want to multiply first, we'll just have to add brackets to indicate as such. Now let's see how juxtaposition does. If we want to multiply first, that'll do so by default. If we want to divide first, well, here we have a little trick up our sleeve. Since division is the same thing as a fraction, and since multiplication by a fraction means you multiply by the numerator, we can rewrite this equation, like so, without needing to use any brackets. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner. Juxtaposition will always be able to write more cleanly, and additionally will better reflect how the expression would be written algebraically. In the criteria of reducing the amount of brackets, implied multiplication is clearly better. And once you're at college-level math, it's just a default way of multiplying, making it functionally identical to multiplication being higher than division. Okay, sure, but that's still not an explanation for why people who were taught PEMDAS often get it wrong. So let's finally dive into the one rule that's been causing so much trouble. There's two parts to it. Multiplication and division have equal precedence, and evaluate from left to right. Let's tackle them one by one. So, why do so many people misunderstand this rule? Why can't people grasp that these operations have equal precedence? Well, you see, in PEMDAS, M comes before D. Okay, now that's done with. Evaluate from left to right. There shouldn't be a problem here. After all, that's how we read text, kinda. But you would be remiss to assume that the way the monkey brain handles language and logic are the same. One eye-tracking study I could find, that was free, examined how subjects read mathematical expressions. It's about designing math UI for technical documents, but for our purposes, the thing that's interesting is that everyone reads math not from left to right, but from the variables or operators first. So no, this rule is not intuitive. And it should be clear now why it's terribly easy to misinterpret. Okay, wait, actually I want to return to this point. One thing that genuinely infuriates me about PEMDAS defenders is that whenever it's brought up it's ambiguous which operation to do first, defenders treat it like the ultimate gotcha when they point out it isn't technically ambiguous, and then ignore the fact that it goes against basic human instinct. If you're stressed out of your mind in an exam, or once you've forgotten 90% of everything from school, your mind will just default to that one mnemonic, with no memory of the true lesson behind it. It directly conflicts with how PEMDAS is taught, that is, with every operation being in a particular order. We're monkeys, we're pattern-recognizing machines, and perhaps the easiest pattern to recognize is things being in order. And you can't teach anything if it contradicts whatever intuitions people have already built. And if you ignore this fact, people will learn nothing, or worse. Some people have suggested it should be written like so, to show which operations are carried out simultaneously. No one does, because it's ugly and writing brackets is annoying. Also, the irony of PEMDAS itself needing to be clarified with brackets is hilarious. To me. And hopefully someone else now too. A more refined suggestion would be something like Gemma, which doesn't even mention subtraction and division, and treats them, respectively, as addition by a negative number, and as multiplication by the multiplicative inverse of a number. Imagine having a system that encouraged the learning of actual math instead of glorified memory exercises. What an idea. One of the most common proposals is that people should just write clearly, dammit. Get rid of the obulus and write division as fractions, and if ambiguity could arise, just write brackets to clarify. Firstly, telling people to please behave nicely is the most non-solution solution in existence and has never worked. Secondly, as much as I agree with this point, until the day every writing application has LaTeX support, we will often be confined to a single line of text, and we need to deal with that. And finally, the actual real solution to the problem, do it the way mathematicians are already doing it, and just teach the order of operations. Teach students how the operations work from the ground up, how they relate to each other, and they'll be able to solve equations in whatever order they want. No acronyms, no mnemonics. Don't hide the logic in layers of hyperbole, because that's the fundamental problem with PEMDAS, the fact that it exists in the first place. It shows up in math classes, law, rules to be followed, and that's how students internalize it, and they'll go through life thinking that math has a set order, and when life inevitably confronts them, they'll argue about who's right and who's wrong. PEMDAS makes you worse at math, because PEMDAS isn't math. It's grammar, in a disguise. The order of operations is about language. It's about taking an idea and communicating it. It's not a natural law. It's not a rule to be followed. It's a tool, and its value can only be judged not by its form, but by how it's used. It's still a valuable discussion, and it should be had, but we need to realize what we're even talking about. There can be many ways of writing the same thing, but they ultimately mean the same thing. So instead of wasting time teaching language in math class, maybe just teach math.